Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to another organ recital in our series Music at Midday, presented by St Paul's Cathedral, London, Ontario. Today's short programme consists of pieces, most of which have been chosen by you, the listeners. Thank you so much for the requests that have come in, and I think I've nearly taken care of all of those, but it means we have a very mixed programme for you today. We begin with a piece by a composer from New Zealand, C.S. Lang. He was born in Hastings, New Zealand in 1891 and then emigrated to Britain at a very young age. He was educated at the Royal College of Music and was taught there by Walter Parrott and Charles Villiers Stanford. Very much an educator, he spent most of his life as a schoolmaster and in fact wrote many tutor books for organists and some very attractive compositions as well. His tuba tune that I'm going to play for you is perhaps his most popular piece for the organ, and it features the tuba stop or the trumpet stop in the right hand. So the first piece on today's program, Tuba Tune in D by New Zealand composer C.S. Lang. Have requests for the music of J.S. Bach, and two pieces are on my list right now, and I'm going to perform one of them for you today. It is a chorale prelude, Nun Komm de Heiden Heiland, Now Come, O Blessed Saviour. It's a piece that uses the Lutheran chorale melody in the right hand, and it's decorated with ornamentation, trills, and it's played on a solo stop, and an accompaniment played by the left hand and the pedals. So the next piece on the programme, the chorale prelude of J.S. Bach, Nun Komm de Heiden Heiland. Thank you. After J.S. Bach, perhaps the next most popular composer for the organ is Mendelssohn, who we know very well, of course, for his wonderful oratorios, especially Elijah. But Mendelssohn, being an organist, wrote frequently for the instrument and has left us with some beautiful music. And one of the pieces that's being requested is the finale, the very last movement of his sixth organ sonata. When I was at St Paul's Cathedral as a chorister in London, England, the organist of the day, Sir John Dykesbauer, always used to say that this was perhaps one of the most beautiful pieces ever written for the organ. So the next piece on the programme, I'm going to play the last two movements of the sonata, the fugue and then the beautiful finale, which features the lovely flute stops by Mendelssohn.
Thank you.
The next piece on the programme is by the German composer Max Reger, who lived at the end of the 19th century. He lived just to the age of 43, but in his short life wrote a lot of music, most of it for organ, although he did write for orchestral forces as well. He was very much a traditionalist in terms of his form. He loved the works of J.S. Bach. And when he wrote, even though there are a lot of notes and very much in a romantic vein, in terms of the form, he would often revert to forms from the Baroque period. And even when he was writing in a fairly free style, as this piece that I'm going to play for you now demonstrates, he uses an early form by taking the Gregorian chant, the chant of the Te Deum, and using it, as it were, as like an idée fixe right through the piece. You keep hearing the theme of the Te Deum over and over again. It's played right at the outset, and it repeats and finishes at the end on what we call full organ. So the next piece on the programme, the organ fantasia, the short work called Te Deum by Max Reger. From Germany into France. The next piece on the programme is by the organist-composer Alexandre Guillemont. Guillemont was a wonderful organist and composer and apparently a brilliant improviser. He was organist at La Trinité Church in Paris for 30 years and he succeeded Vidor as professor of organ at the Paris Conservatory. He was a wonderful teacher as well as an actual player. Most of his music was written for the organ and is very, very tuneful. and much of it is based on Gregorian chant, a little bit like the Rega Te Deum that I've just played. But I'm going to play a gentler movement from the works of Alexandre Guilmant, from his seventh sonata for organ in F major, the Cantabile movement, which uses the beautiful flute, string and clarinet stops of the organ. So the next piece, Cantabile by Alexandre Guilmant. The next piece on the programme is by English composer Herbert Howells. Howells was born in 1892 in Gloucestershire and spent a lot of the time in his early informative years at the Cathedral of Gloucester, where he was an articled pupil to the organist Herbert Brewer. After studies in Gloucester at the Cathedral, he moved to London, where he attended the Royal College of Music and was a student of Charles Villiers Stanford. He knew Vaughan Williams and was much influenced by his music, and Herbert Howells also loved the Tudor repertoire as well, and much of his compositions show the mark of Tudor composers. The piece I'm going to play for you today is a psalm prelude. Howells wrote two sets of psalm preludes for the organ, three pieces in each set. And when he wrote this particular psalm prelude, it's the last one of the second set, the storm clouds of war were beginning to appear over Europe. He actually wrote this piece in 1939. He was a very religious person, and I believe that once he saw the atrocities coming of war, he started having doubts about his faith, and he started to put all of his energies into composing. And perhaps this piece reflects what is just about to happen in Europe. Anyway, the psalm that it's based on is number 33, verse 3, "Sing unto him a new song." And Howells paints the words in the music by using the organ in a very jazzy fashion. It's very bright, rhythmic and articulate most of the way through, has a central section which dies away and then it builds up again and finishes with all the stops drawn on full organ. So the next piece, the Psalm Prelude by English composer Herbert Howells. Thank you. The final work on today's programme is perhaps the lighter item of the day. It's a piece by a composer from Liverpool, where the Fab Four, of course, originated, the Beatles, but this piece was written by the organist at the Anglican Cathedral, Noel Rawstone. He was there from 1955 to 1980, and in retirement, he started writing a lot of organ works, very useful for us church organists, some wonderful voluntaries, and so on. But occasionally, a great recital piece as well. And this particular piece, I won't say much about it, except see if you can pick out all the different tunes that you hear. Certainly Noel Rawstone had tongue firmly in cheek when he was writing this particular piece called Hornpipe Humoresque. But enjoy it, and thank you for tuning in to today's recital.